Hello and welcome to Pixarize the Scene on Edwards Syndrome, part of our playlist on the chromosomal abnormalities. I don't know about you, but when I think of Edwards, Edward Scissorhands comes to mind. Take a look at Edward here, shaping this bush into a turtle. If you watched the movie, you would know that Edward uses scissorhands to shape plants into beautiful sculptures. Just remember Edward here, and you'll quickly bring up this scene on Edwards Syndrome. Let's fill in the rest of the scene. First, take a look at this campaign sign here, with the words "Vote" written on it. You see, what the movie didn't tell you is that Edward was actually running for office in his neighborhood. Which office again? Was it city sculptor or barber? Anyways, this vote sign here should make you think of the number 18, as you need to be 18 years old in order to vote. The three checkboxes on this sign should help you remember that Edwards syndrome is caused by trisomy 18, or having three copies instead of the usual two of chromosome 18. Now, let's focus on our candidate, where we've drawn the clinical features of the syndrome. There's a lot to remember here, but we'll go over the features one by one so you'll be ready to recognize them on test day. To begin, notice how Edward has a very small jaw and is wearing headgear to correct it. I guess his doctors thought that his jaw was more important to fix than his hands. Anyways, this small jaw with headgear should help you remember the micrognathia, or small jaw, that is a key clinical finding in Edwards syndrome. Next, take a glance at Edward's ears. See how they're positioned low on his head, and how he's wearing a bunch of gauges and other piercings? I always thought that Edward Scissorhands had that rock star look with his clothing and piercings. Anyways, these low-set ears with many piercings should help you remember the low-set and malformed ears that are classically seen in patients with Edwards syndrome. Afterwards, shift your attention to Edward's hands. Of course he's got scissors for hands. He is called Edward Scissorhands, after all. But did you notice that Edwards is clenching his fists, causing his blade-like fingers to look crossed? We've drawn his hands in this way to help you remember another high-yield feature of the syndrome: clenched hands with overlapping fingers. The way exam writers test you on this information is they include it in the presentation of a newborn baby who has not received any prenatal care. You have to recognize that clenched hands and overlapping fingers is a dead giveaway for Edwards syndrome. Just picture Edward Scissorhands clenching his hands with overlapping blades, and you'll have no problem remembering this on test day. Next, notice Edward's big man bun. You could say that his hair really accentuates the back of his head. This is here to help you remember the prominent occiput, or back of the head, that is another key finding in Edwards syndrome. Afterwards, take a look at the plant sculpture that Edward is shaping. He's making a turtle, which is Pixarize's recurring symbol for developmental delay. Patients with Edwards syndrome typically present with severe intellectual disability, with delayed or non-existent progress through the usual developmental milestones. If you look closely, you'll also notice that Edward has accidentally chopped off the head of the turtle in a moment of carelessness. This is just classic Edward Scissorhands, who has the best of intentions, but just keeps making accidents because of his blade-like hands. Anyways, this fatal mistake should help you remember that Edward syndrome is usually fatal at 1 year of age. Therefore, most clinical vignettes on Edward syndrome involve fetuses and newborns. The last two findings of Edward syndrome are depicted on this rocking chair, on which Edward periodically sits to take a rest from the hard job of his campaign. This rocking chair drawn here is our recurring symbol for rocker bottom feet, which is seen in patients with Edward syndrome. Next, take a close look at the heart-shaped cushion on this chair. See how we've drawn several seams dividing the heart into four chambers? The two chambers up top represent the atria, just like how the bottom chambers represent the ventricles. You can tell that Edward has been sitting here because his blade-like hands have carelessly sliced through these seams connecting the atria and the ventricles. This is here to help you remember the high-yield finding of congenital heart disease in Edwards syndrome. The most common defects observed are atrial septal defects and ventricular septal defects, which are openings in the septa or seams separating the right and left sides of the heart. The abnormal connections allow blood from the right and left side of the heart to mix, which can be seen in an echocardiogram. Just picture our heart cushion here, and you'll have these clinical findings under wraps for your exam. Whew, well, that wasn't so bad, right? Unfortunately, exam writers want you to know more than the clinical presentation here. They also want you to recognize the lab values seen during pregnancy. For this, recall how our friend Edward is hard at work doing odd jobs around the neighborhood to win the people's vote. He's making sculptures, walking dogs, and even babysitting. However, while Edward has a great heart, he just keeps messing things up. Let's take a closer look at how he's doing this. First, take a look down below at this puppy that Edward was walking. See how it's running away with a piece of chorizo in its mouth? A puppy is our recurring symbol for PAP-A, and chorizo is our recurring symbol for human chorionic gonadotropin, or HCG. This puppy and chorizo low on the ground in this scene should help you remember the lab findings of decreased PAP-A and beta-HCG in the first trimester. But everything just keeps going wrong for Edward. Our chorizo-carrying puppy has pulled his inhibitory road sign down, as well as a stroller also tied to the leash. This is here to help you remember the second trimester lab findings seen in Edwards syndrome. The inhibitory road sign is our recurring symbol for inhibin A, while this stroller is our recurring symbol for estriol. This estriol stroller also has three wheels because estriol is an estrogen characterized by three alcoholic OH groups. The stroller also has a hanging alphabet toy with the letters A, F, and P, which should help you remember the substance AFP. Everything is falling down because Edwards syndrome is characterized by decreases in all of these labs during the second trimester: HCG, inhibin A, estriol, and AFP. This seems like a lot to remember, but I want you to relax. Exam writers don't typically ask you to distinguish between first and second trimester labs. Instead, they'll give you a table listing all of these labs, where each answer choice shows a different combination of arrows representing an increase or decrease in these lab values. For simplicity, just picture our puppy pulling everything down to recall how Edwards syndrome is characterized by a decrease in everything. Therefore, the right answer will be down arrows for PAP-A, HCG, inhibin A, estriol, and AFP. And that's it for Edwards syndrome. To quickly review, Edwards syndrome is caused by trisomy 18, and usually presents with micrognathia, low-set ears, and clenched hands with overlapping fingers in a newborn baby. Important complications to remember include ASDs and VSDs on echocardiogram of the heart. Lab values are characterized by a decrease in everything, including PAP-A, HCG, inhibin A, estriol, and AFP. Edward Scissorhands just can't get anything right, can he? I hope he wins the election. We'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching. For more videos like these, click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also check out the interactive version of this image at pixarize.com by following the link in the description. If you like what we're doing, share with your friends on social media, and we'll keep making great content like this. We'll see you next time.